I am Dr. Vishnu Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Education, Jain Vishwabharati Institute, Ladnu. Today I discuss pheromones. A pheromone is a chemical that an animal produces which changes the behavior of another animal of the same species. Many people do not know that pheromones trigger other behaviors in the animal of the same species apart from sexual behavior. Pheromones, unlike most other hormones, are ectohormones. They are secreted outside the body and they influence the behavior of another individual. Pheromones are similar to hormones but work outside of the body. They induce activity in other individuals such as sexual arousal. Most insects use pheromones to communicate. Some chemicals have been investigated for pheromones action in human, but evidence is weak. Many pheromones products can be purchased online, but research suggested that these are ineffective. There are four types of pheromones: releaser, primer, signaler, and modulator. First, releaser pheromones. These elicit an immediate response, and the response is rapid and reliable. They are usually linked to sexual attraction. Second, primer pheromones. These take longer to get a response. They can, for example, influence the development of reproductive physiology, including menstrual cycle in female, puberty, and the success of failure of pregnancy. They can alter hormone level in other beings. In some mammals, scientists found that females who had become pregnant and were exposed to primer pheromones from another male could spontaneously abort the fetus. Next, singular pheromones. These provide information. They may help the mother to recognize her newborn by scent. Father cannot usually do this. Signaler pheromones give out our genetic odor print. Modulator pheromones. They can either alter or synchronize bodily function. They are usually found in sweat. In animal experiments, scientists found that when placed on the upper lip of females, they become less tense and more relaxed. Modulator hormones may also affect a female's monthly cycle. Functions: raising an alarm, signaling a food trail, tracking sexual arousal, tell other female insect to lay their eggs elsewhere, bond between mother and offspring, warning another animal to back off. It is believed that the first pheromone, bombicol, was identified in 1959. Bombicol is secreted by female moths and is designed to attract males. The pheromone signal can travel enormous distance, even at low concentrations. Experts say that the pheromone system of insect is much easier to understand than that of mammals, which do not have a simple stereotype insect behavior. It is believed that mammals detect pheromones through an organ in the nose called the vomeronasal organ, or Jacobson organ. This connects to the hypothalamus in the brain. The VNO in humans consists of just pits that probably do not do anything. Interestingly, the VNO is clearly present in the fetus but atrophies before birth. If humans do respond to hormones, most likely they use their normal olfactory system. Pheromones are commonly used in insect control. They can be used as bait to attract males into a trap, prevent them from mating, or to disorient them. Humans Gustav Jaeger, 1832-1917, a German doctor and hygienist, is thought to be the first scientist to put forward the idea of human pheromones, which he called anthropenes. Researchers at the University of Chicago claimed that they managed to link the synchronization of women menstrual cycle to unconscious odor cues. The head researcher was called Martha McClintock, and the phenomena was called the McClintock effects. When exposing a group of women to a scent of sweet from other women, their menstrual cycle either accelerated or slowed down, depending on whether the sweat was collected before, during, or after ovulation. The scientists said that the pheromones collected before ovulation shortened the ovarian cycle, while the pheromone collected during ovulation lengthened it. However, recent analysis of McClintock study and methodology have questioned its validity. Thanks.